Hi, this is Anne with SVG Cut File, and today I'm going to show you how to edit or change the text in an SVG file in Cricut Design Space. All right, let's get started. First, I'm going to click on Cricut Design Space to open it up. I'll resize the window, and I'm going to load an SVG file. So I'll come over here to Upload, Upload Image, and then I'll Browse. Now, I want to show you what happens with an SVG if someone's tried to save live text in it. By live text, I mean typable text, where you can just highlight and retype what's there. Here's what happens. We get this error message that says, this contains items that aren't supported text elements. Do you want to import anyway? And we'll continue. And then there's nothing here. All that's on this SVG is text. So, probably if there are other things, they would also show up here. And then we'll hit save. And when I click on it and insert it, we get another error message that says there is a failure. So with Cricut, no SVG can have live typable text inside it. So every SVG file that you get from Etsy or you download online or something like that should have expanded text that you cannot type in. I'm going to go ahead and upload an image from Etsy. We'll browse. I'm going to double click on this birth announcement and we'll load the SVG file and say open. I'll save it and I'll insert it. Okay, so we have text here, but we cannot type into it. I'm going to zoom out a little bit here. Now this is a template, so that just means that you can delete this text and then type new text where it was. Now some Etsy designers will include this same font. And you can install the font and then use your text tool and type in and then go ahead and choose that font, recolor it, and then delete this one. If you don't have the font and it's not included with the file, you'll just need to choose a similar font. Okay, with this file, there is also a template file that comes with it. So although this isn't really necessary, I'm going to go ahead and upload the other one too. And I'll show you how it works. We'll save it. And we'll choose it and then insert it. Okay, so I like to have both of them up on my screen at the same time so I can see what's going on. Okay, so let's switch out the text here and put our own text in. First, we'll wanna click on this and ungroup the image. I'm gonna get on my text tool and I'm gonna type a new baby name. This baby will be named Gemma. So now we can click on this and just drag it right up to the corner of this block and then we'll resize it. We'll click the lock button over here so that we can resize non-proportionally and just stretch to fill that box. Now I'm going to come up here and choose a different color. All right, that's looking pretty good. I'll make sure I have the box selected. It looks like I've got the text right now, so I'm going to move it up out of the way. I'll need to ungroup all this. So I'll come up here and ungroup. Then I'll delete this rectangle. I'll select the text again and just move it back down. And we can do that with each of these boxes. You can just type in your own text, change it to the right font, and then stretch it to the size of the box. And then it'll end up looking a lot like your template. And of course, when you're done getting all of your text in there, you can go ahead and delete the extra rectangles that are just meant to be used as a guide. All right, if you like this video, please click on the like button and I'll see you next week with another crafting tutorial. Thank you.